Hello everyone, welcome back to a vlog video. I had taken these videos on different days. So adding a week's video in today's vlog. So today after a long drive back home, I had shown this meat kebab recipe on how to prepare and store it in the freezer. I had kept it 10 minutes before out at room temperature. Shallow fried it in a tawa and an evening snack is ready. So today we'll be going to Mantri Mall for few shopping. I had been here maybe 6 months back. After that we had not gone to Mantri Mall. So today we are here for few shopping. So now we are at the Mantri Mall. We had been here in the morning, maybe around 11. So the mall is not filled as earlier. Only few members are here. Home center does not allow to take any videos, so I couldn't make a video over there. So today I'll be making a beef biryani and beef dry roast. For the beef biryani, I'm grinding green chili, pudina leaf and coriander leaf into fine paste. I have washed and cleaned these meat. Add 2 tablespoons of thick curds, salt as per taste, 1/2 teaspoon of whole jeera, 1/2 teaspoon of whole fennel seed, 1/4 teaspoon of peppercorn, few clove, 1 elaichi, 2 cinnamon stick, 1 teaspoon of coriander powder, 1/2 teaspoon of turmeric powder, 1/2 teaspoon of chili powder, 1/2 teaspoon of garam masala powder, 1 bay leaf and the ground masala. Mix well and marinate for 1/2 hour. To a cooker, add 3 teaspoons of cooking oil. Add 1 large sliced onion and fry until translucent. Add 1 teaspoon of ginger garlic paste and fry until the raw smell goes. Add the marinated meat. Fry on high flame for 2 minutes. Now add enough water for the meat to cook. Pressure cook until the meat is done. Take a non-stick vessel, add nearly 2 to 3 tablespoons of cooking oil. Add one finely chopped onion. Keep frying until light brown in color. Now add one cinnamon stick, one elaichi, few cloves and peppercorn. Add half teaspoon of ginger garlic paste and fry until the raw smell goes. Add the cooked meat. Cook for 2 to 3 minutes. Add pepper powder, garam masala powder. Give a mix. When the masala is almost ready, add few drops of lime juice. Give a mix. Now place few sliced tomato. Sliced brinjal. Sliced carrot. Few pudina leaves and coriander leaves. Two to three slitted green chili. I have cooked the rice for 80%. Now drain the water and add this rice on the top of it. Finally, sprinkle few yellow color and ghee. Put it on dum for 10 minutes. Now to prepare a beef roast, I'm adding one roughly chopped onion, 2 to 3 green chili, 1 teaspoon of oil to a cooker. Add the washed meat piece. Ginger garlic paste, coriander powder, chili powder, turmeric powder, garam masala powder, jeera powder, salt as per taste, few curry leaves. Add enough water for the meat to cook. Give a mix. Add a pinch of hing. Add one chopped tomato, few drops of vinegar, mix well and pressure cook until the meat is done. To a kadai, add 1 tablespoon of cooking oil with 1 roughly chopped onion. Keep frying until it turns light brown in color. Add half teaspoon of ginger garlic paste and fry until the raw smell goes. Add coriander powder, turmeric powder, jeera powder, garam masala powder, pepper powder, fennel seed powder. Keep frying until you get a good aroma of the masala. Now add the cooked meat. Keep frying on medium flame. Add few curry leaves and keep frying until the masala is completely dried and coated on the meat. Now the meat is ready. So a tasty beef roast is also ready. Try this biryani, it's very tasty. The aroma of the brinjal carrot gives a good flavor to the biryani. So today I'll be making few DIY. To make a tissue holder, I have taken a use and throw container and I have a stick. So add the cement mix to the container. Place the stick at the center and allow it to dry completely. Once it dries, I'll be giving a color to it. So my son will be giving a color. So he has completed the work very neatly. He has given some yellow spots as a design. So this is how it looks after completely dried. And a very beautiful DIY tissue holder is ready. To add a decor piece to the stand table, what I had done few days back, I'm using this old clock. I have removed the needle. Will be sticking this fabric at the base. Also, I have this golden lace. I'll be sticking it above the fabric. Now replace the glass and the screws, and a simple decor piece is also ready. So this was my today's vlog. If you are a new viewer, please do not forget to subscribe my channel. We'll be back soon. Until then, bye and take care.